Tonight, we finally hear from the Arizona State Senate Republican who called for the so-called audit of the 2020 presidential election ballots in Phoenix. She's avoided talking until now. CNN's Kyung Lah caught up with her. Here's her report.
Good morning, Senator Fann.
You may not recognize Arizona Senate President Karen Fann.
Let's get this thing done.
But she's the elusive leader behind the notorious so-called audit happening in Maricopa County, Arizona.
I don't know what's legit, what isn't legit, but why wouldn't we want to answer those questions?
Because you're questioning democracy.
No, I'm questioning the integrity of the election system.
Which is the backbone of democracy.
That's right. Which means we should have full 100% confidence in our democracy and in our election system.
But you're talking about trying to disprove conspiracies.
If I have to, yes. Why wouldn't we? If somebody says something is out there, I would love to be able to say, that's not true, guys.
Aren't you raising more questions by giving rise to these conspiracy theories?
No. I'm answering questions.
After declining a dozen requests from CNN to talk, we finally caught up with her in the Senate parking lot. Despite two previous audits in Maricopa County that found no widespread fraud, Fann says this third review is needed. Over the last month, we've seen this little-known subcontractor the Republican-led Senate hired, Cyber Ninjas, use UV lights, hunting for non-existent watermarks on ballots, and high-tech cameras looking for foreign fibers and photocopied ballots. Here's why, says Fann.
Okay, so let me ask you a question. Mm-hmm. Are you 100% confident that every vote that came in Arizona or any other state, or can you say emphatically 100% that no dead people voted, that ballots weren't filled out by other people, that the chain of custody from the minute people voted their ballots, that the chain of custody was accurate and on target the entire time. Can you tell me that?
I can say that what the data shows us
is that
there was no widespread fraud.
I didn't say there was fraud.
But you just said chain of custody.
Yeah, chain of custody.
Dead people. These things are all fraud.
Well, I have asked you a question. Uh-huh. Can you honestly tell me in all the states that no ballots from people that are already deceased were not filled out and sent in?
I can tell you that what the data has shown overwhelmingly is that election, this was the most secure election in American history.
Okay, but you can't answer that question either, can you?
I'm answering it. I'm telling you.
No,
that
you're telling me what the data says. I asked.
And
you
the
were
data
asking me
is what we should be driven by.
What the facts are may be the disconnect. Fann defends the pro-Donald Trump media organization One America News Network, or OAN, as being the only outlet given extensive access to the review.
First of all, when we talk about transparency, from day one, the entire process has been live streaming, so anybody...
On OAN, with cameras controlled by OAN.
Are you saying that OAN is not a credible news source? Are you
yes.
saying that? Okay. I'll remember that. CNN is saying that OAN is not a credible one.
Yes.
Okay, very good.
OAN personalities have fundraised for the Arizona audit, and a pro-Trump nonprofit claims it has raised $1.7 million for the audit. Fann says when the audit nears its end, the public will learn who is exactly paying for this. For now, she says taxpayers are covering the first $150,000.
Well, we are paying the $150,000. We are paying for some of the security, and we are paying for the cost of the Coliseum. Well, we're paying for our fair share. Anything over and above that is being covered by others. I do not know who they are, but I know from the get-go there was a lot of grassroots people. I have been told that there are people sending in $10, $50 checks, $100, because they want to see this audit done.
Fann's decision to continue with this audit is backed by the Republican majority in Arizona Senate.
It looks like they're looking for, they're chasing conspiracies.
Or debunking conspiracies. That's another thing. Look at that. See, everybody wants to twist that word around. How about debunking conspiracy?
And how long do you believe that this process should go?
As long as it takes.
Do you believe this is helping democracy?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Will you do this every election?
It will be a lesson in democracy that we answer people's questions, and I want the people, I don't care if you're in Arizona or any state across the nation, if we have those kind of doubts, we owe it to them to answer their questions. This will be the basis of a gold standard.
Kyung Lah joins us now from Phoenix. It's interesting. She's saying essentially that if anybody feels like something wasn't fair, then there will always be audits because people will always think something isn't fair. Whoever loses will think it's not fair. And at some point that this will just continue on and on, that this is the new normal.
She quantified it. She said if it's only 2% of voters who think that it's not fair, you can ignore that. But because there are so many, she says, who do not believe this election result, that they have to chase all of these conspiracies. But Republicans here in Maricopa County say that that is not being able to tell the difference between fact and fiction. And Karen Fann, somebody who the Republicans in Maricopa County really deeply admire, have known for many years, Anderson, they say she is chasing a fiction.
I flagged as a bolo last night, but you know what? It's even bigger than, and more important than I made it, okay? You have to look at who's behind the fraudit in Arizona, and that's why I call it fraudit, because the more you learn and the more you look, the worse it is. It may be crazy, but it is real and happening, and there is a new conductor helping to drive the crazy train. It should tell you everything you need to know about the legitimacy of this effort to try to overturn the presidential election results in the state's largest county of Arizona, 7 months after the vote. The Republicans say they did it right. They looked at it twice. The people who are on the board overseeing it, who are all Republican, don't understand why this is happening. But now you will. This man is former Overstock CEO Patrick Byrne. He has turned crazed Trump sympathizer. Very, very passionate about it. He is helping bankroll this clown show in Maricopa County with a group he runs called the America Project. His group is apparently helping not just raise money, but to decide who counts the ballots. They are recruiting the volunteers as a liaison with the Republican-controlled state Senate. He's launched a website that aims to raise nearly $3 million for the sham, and claims to have already raised well over half that to prove Trump was the rightful winner. Now, you may be thinking, so Byrne, I like Overstock. What's the big deal? Byrne is the guy who says he was present at that bonkers meeting at the White House in the final days of Trump's presidency about martial law, the one attended by that Kraken Sidney Powell and the disgraced former national security advisor Michael Flynn. There was allegedly a clash over talk of martial law and seizing voting machines to try to overturn the election. Byrne was there. Byrne is the guy who came on this program a couple years ago with one of the wildest allegations I've ever heard, saying the so-called deep state was directing him before the last presidential election to pursue a romantic relationship with convicted Russian operative Maria Butina. You remember this? The FBI wanted you to continue your association to get information. They never told you you needed to have a romantic relationship with somebody.
Well, eventually, yes, they did.
They told you that you had to have a romantic relationship?
That's what I'm getting to. This gal, Maria, oh my gosh, highest national priority. And they said, and the very honorable men and women, the men in black, they said, we want to be clear. This never happens in the United States. We are the good guys. Oh, we don't work like the bad guys, but we need to ask you to rekindle a romantic relationship with Maria Butina. And
members of the FBI that you're sure were members of the FBI asked you to do this. And you know their names.
And I know their names.
Here's the problem. Former top FBI officials said, no, he doesn't. There's nothing to this. Then Byrne kind of flamed out into oblivion, resigned from Overstock over the conspiracy talk. But now he's back again as one of the main forces behind what's happening in Arizona. The Cyber Ninjas, it's a funny name. But the fact that this is the man organizing this situation, picking or helping to pick the people who are going to count the ballots, bolo.